What does it take to solve problems, help others, and improve the world around you? Curiosity? Creativity? Persistence? What it takes are the skills of an engineer.
Hi, my name is Andrew. I'm an engineer at Boeing, and I work on developing methods to predict how airplanes will fly.
My name is Josh, and I'm an engineer at Boeing, where I do computational fluid dynamics, where we use computers to calculate how air flows over wings and airplanes.
Andrew and Josh work to improve the efficiency of how an airplane flies. They study the effects of air flowing around wings to generate lift and drag, and one way to do that is by testing wings in a wind tunnel. A wind tunnel is basically a big tube where engineers place a plane, wing, or model and blow air over it.
So rather than having the airplane fly through the air, we make the air fly over the airplane. And that way we can watch it in one spot and measure how the forces behave and how much the air is pushing in different directions.
When flying an airplane, the weight of the airplane pulls it down toward the earth, and we need to counteract that with lift to pull it up and keep it in the air.
Lift is the upward force that enables aircraft to fly and stay in the sky. In order to generate lift, objects use wings, and the shape of the wing is very important.
An airfoil is the shape of the wing when you look at it from the side. You can change the way air flows around the airfoil by changing its shape. The ideal shape of an airfoil changes depending on how you want to use that airfoil, but most of them boil down to a teardrop shape, where it has a nice curve in the front and it tapers to a sharp end at the back.
Engineers design wings to increase the speed of the air on the top of the wing and slow it down underneath the wing. The curved front of the airfoil helps do just that. The slower air on the bottom acts as a pushing force under the wing and pushes the aircraft up, creating lift. By using wind tunnels, engineers are able to measure how air moves over wings, but it can take a very long time to build an accurate model of the wing and get time in the tunnel.
If we do it inside the computer, we can do it much faster.
So Andrew and Josh basically create virtual wind tunnels, which are great at providing information that is harder to physically test, like when a plane is maneuvering or turning sharply. But to collect all the right data, Andrew has to do some math.
So one of the things that we do is we end up representing essentially every molecule or region of space by an equation. But when we do that, there's just so many equations, we can't write them down and solve them on paper. We're also often dealing with like 5 billion equations at once.
Wow, that is impressive. How can we use these ideas to build something?
In this design challenge, you'll design a flying wing and use a fan to test it.
You're going to build a wing that is able to generate as much lift as possible. You'll have to not only think about the shape of the wing, but also the angle of the wing and the stability of your entire structure. You can test your wing by using a fan to simulate a wind tunnel. And remember, if it doesn't work at first, you can learn from mistakes and try again.
One of the things about being an engineer is that you never know how much you don't know. You've got to always keep looking and trying to understand a little bit better and get deeper understanding about all the different sides of things.
Want to engineer your own wing and test it in your own wind tunnel? Check out the activity on Curiosity Machine.